We welcome you back to Boston and the World Figure Skating Championships final flight for the ladies short program. Here is the one to beat in this competition, 16-year-old Evgenia Medvedeva of Russia.
And the most impressive thing in her short program is the fact that all three jumping passes are at the end of the program. She takes her time at the beginning of the program, gets into the ice, feels her edges. Once that bonus hits, she's a jumping machine.
The only skater who has beaten her this year, her teammate, 17-year-old Yelena Radionova.
And she was last year's Russian prodigy, and we've seen one come out every year for the past 5 years. And what's so impressive to me is that she's adapted into her sophomore season. She's grown a lot. She's matured a lot. They've packaged her from a cute little girl into an elegant woman, and she's taking those steps in stride, and her technical ability is just as strong as it was last season, and it's kept her relevant, where some of the other girls in the years past, we haven't seen them at the top of their game.
A skater in her second world championships, she finished sixth at last year's world, 19-year-old Rika Hongo of Japan.
And Rika just seems like nothing really bothers her. She goes out, it's her second year. She doesn't look particularly frazzled when she's on the ice, and that translates to the fact that she doesn't really make a lot of mistakes. If she goes out and does her job, she's able to put up those big numbers. But if she really wants to get into that podium talk, she's going to have to light a bit of a fire into her performance.
This diminutive little skater, 4'10", she is powerful, small but mighty. She's just coming off a win at the Four Continents, the national champion of Japan, Satoko Miyahara.
And she has taken such a big step this year as an artist. She's so tiny and adorable that her taking these mature roles in her programs was a bit of a risk, and she has done it so well. And you can see as this season has progressed, she's gotten stronger and stronger.
Well, her American teammates were on fire in the earlier flight, and I think Gracie Gold is hoping to follow in their footsteps here, Ryan. Big moment.
You know that Gracie realizes with Worlds in Boston, this is a big opportunity, and Gracie's a competitor. She knows that Ashley went out and skated well and put up a big number, and the Gracie that we know does not shy away from competition. She's going to come out aggressive, and as long as she can control her energy, she's going to be capable of putting up just a huge number because of jumping combinations like that triple lutz, triple toe, which is the best in the world.
So Gracie skates second to last. The final skater you see tonight, another Russian teenager, Anna Pogorilia.
And she is such a great talent, but she is the most volatile of these girls. She's capable of doing all the big tricks. She's also capable of missing all three jumps in the program, which is very scary as a coach and as a judge. When you're watching someone like that skate, you're holding your breath every single time that they leave the ice.
Skaters now finishing up their warm-up here in Boston. And when we come back, we'll have the final flight of ladies. Back in Boston and on the ice, getting a last-minute encouragement from her coach. It's Evgenia Medvedeva, and she is beginning her quest to become the first woman since American Kimi Meisner 10 years ago to win the title in her first attempt, just 16 years of age.
On the ice now, representing Russia, Evgenia Medvedeva.
She has the highest short program score this season. Here is Evgenia Medvedeva of Russia.
Thank you.
flip a little forward, no combination. She hangs on, but she has to get that triple toe on later. Double axel, much better landing. Triple loop, reaches back and pulls off a beautiful triple toe.
Yevgenia Medvedeva certainly fighting back, missing the first triple-triple attempt, but was able to think on her feet, added in later. Keep your eyes on the score in the left. Technically, she has the lead over Ashley Wagner. Those scores can change, so we'll wait to see how it plays out. Ryan, what did you think of her performance?
Well, one of the benefits of training yourself to do all the jumping passes at the end of the program when you're tired is the fact that when something goes wrong, you have the strength and you have the knowledge that you're capable of doing a triple toe late in the program on a triple loop. That's a very difficult combination to do a triple toe on the landing of a triple loop. But she fought through and she had the intelligence to get the combination in. But here's a look at that triple flip. She breaks forward and makes the decision not to reach back and go for that triple toe. But she knew in the back of her mind that she had the ability to do the triple loop, triple toe. And that's such a difficult thing when the first jump doesn't go the way that you've planned, to have the confidence to stick to your rhythm, stick to your technique, and get the other jumping passes completed in the way that you want them completed. But you have to think the grade of execution on that flip shouldn't be particularly high when she breaks and has the fake reach for the toe and then ends up going to the square landing position. So it'll be interesting to see how that matches up against Ashley Wagner, who was very flawless and delivered a more mature performance from start to finish.
You can see a clean landing there on the second triple jump. And one of the things that is impressive, as you said, she didn't let that first minor glitch get to her. She didn't become flustered. Her double axel, if there is a weakness in her skating, it's her easiest jump, and she nailed that beautifully. So showing such composure at a young age, 16 years of age. Her coach, Terry Tuberidze, was also the coach of Lipnitskaya, who came famous to all of us watching the Olympic Games.
The score, please, for Yevgenia Medvedeva.
Her highest score this season was 74.58.
Her short program score, 73.76.
So a little bit lower than her season's best. She's in first place, but very close with Ashley Wagner. It is going to be a fight all the way. She would have liked to have seen higher scores. She knows that those scores can be caught. A lot of great skaters still to skate, including her teammate, 17-year-old Yelena Radionova. She was last year's bronze medalist. And remember, Yelena is the only skater that was able to beat Medvedeva this season in competition. She skates two melodies of White Knight, choreographed by Alexander Zhulin, world ice dance champion.
D'autres façons de se quitter, quelques éclats de verre auraient peut-être.
Lutz a little forward, fights for a beautiful triple toe. A little forward, it looks like the free leg touchdown, which will come off of the grade of execution. But right back on the double axel, not a lot of flow throughout the jump though.
Elegant presentation by 17-year-old Yelena Radionova of Russia. Yelena Radionova of Russia. We're looking through some of the highlights of her short program. Not perfectly skated.
It was certainly an emotional program. She loves to perform, and that really comes across. But her jumping today was not as crisp as we're accustomed to seeing, and we'll see how that affects her scores when the grade of execution on two of the three jumping passes takes a hit.
Her short program has not been quite as strong this season as her free skate. Her highest score, 71.79. She's going to need a personal best to catch her teammate, an Ashley Wagner of the United States.
Her short program score, 71.70. She is
so about equal to her season's best and good enough for third place. 71.70 for Yelena Radionova.
Please welcome to the ice from Japan, Rika Hongo.
Our next competitor finished sixth at the World Championships last year. She was fourth at her nationals. Here is 19-year-old Rika Hongo of Japan. Skating to music from Cirque du Soleil, choreographed by Akiko Suzuki.
Triple flip out of footwork.
Thank you.
toe, triple toe combination in the second half of the program. And right into the double axle. No problems with any of the jumping passes today.
We're certainly seeing artistically a lot of variety in this women's short program competition, Ryan.
Absolutely. And Rika is performing bigger and harder than I have seen her perform all season long. And this is the stage to do it.
Well, I think the word to sum up that performance is attack and full-on energy. Rika Hongo of Japan, her marks when we come back. Rika Hongo of Japan, closing moments of her short program. She comes here from four continents, where she finished in third place behind Mirai Nagasu. But Ryan, I think that was the strongest short program we've seen from her this season.
Easily, and it's not as if the elements were better, it's just the way that she attacked every nuance, every piece of the music, every step. She was so aggressive throughout the entire duration of the program, and it's so effective when you see a skater that committed to their craft, and it was one of the memorable performances of Rika's career thus far.
Well, her season's best, 64.27.
From Japan. Her short program score, 69.89.
Those marks, please, are 69.89, about 5 points above her season's best, and she is sitting in fourth place behind Radionova of Russia.
She represents Japan. A warm welcome, please, for Satoko Miyahara.
Well, that'll get you going, eh? Words of encouragement. Sweet off the ice. A fierce competitor on the ice. 18 years of age, Satoko Miyahara, last year's world silver medalist. Skating to Fire Dance, choreographed by Tom Dixon.
Opening triple lutz, triple toe combination. Just a beautiful spine throughout both jumps, not a single break. Triple flip. Not a single bobble.
And such detailed choreography by Tom Dixon, and it's just beautiful the way she's interpreting this music. This audience appreciative of the performance by Satoko Miyahara of Japan. Her marks in a moment. We welcome you back to the World Figure Skating Championships in Boston. Ladies short program, two skaters still to come. Next up will be Gracie Gold of the United States, but here are the replays for world silver medalist Satoko Miyahara of Japan.
And she's been so consistent all year long, and that really pays off when you're going in late in the season at the World Championships and you've been clean in the short program all year long. It gives that sense of confidence to the judges that are getting ready to set your marks. And that's going to really bode well for her when this final score comes up. And as we saw earlier, her technical score was ahead of everyone else thus far.
Season's best for 72.48.
Her short program score, 70.72.
70.72. Technical panel may have pulled down the scores on one of her triple jumps. She is ranked in fourth place at the moment.
On the ice now, representing the United States, Gracie Gold.
Gracie Gold, her legendary coach, Mr. Frank Carroll, finished just off the podium in fourth last year, 2.5 points. She had a fabulous free skate, but was down in the short program and had to fight her way back in the game. Her plan this year is to start out fighting in the short program. Gracie Gold, the United States.
Great fight on the landing of the Lutz to reach back for a beautiful triple toe. Triple flip out of footwork. Double axel, a little tight on the landing, but she hangs on.
Now she can let it fly, choreography by Lori Nickel, and looking so elegant in her Louboutin dress with the flash of red in the underskirt. Gracie Gold of the United States, soaking it all in.
From the United States, Gracie Gold.
The performance that she was looking for here in Boston. Fabulous short program, Ryan. Got the jumps done. And totally entertained this audience.
What I loved was the moment that the double axel was executed. She looked like someone set her on fire. She just blew up and took this energy and showed us a side of Gracie that we don't really see very often. She's so down to business, such a strong competitor. But she performed it. She sold the rest of that program, and you could see the genuine excitement. And here's a look at that opening, triple lutz, triple toe. You can see the free leg came out forward, went a little wide, but she reached back and did just a magnificent triple toe. And when you do a triple-triple combination, if the first jump is not executed perfectly, when you reach back and do the second jump to perfection, the overall score of that jump is always going to increase. It's the last look that the judges get that means the most. And this is always the question mark with Gracie, but it's become a strength as of late, the triple flip out of footwork, and she has exercised those demons and looks so confident on the triple flip. And you have to realize when that's a jump that's getting positive grade of executions, all of a sudden, her scores are going to go to a different level that we have not yet seen. The double axel may have been a little bit slow, but the overall energy and performance of this program is going to put up a huge score, and I think we're going to take a look at our new leader.
Ryan, what I love about Gracie Gold skating and in that performance in particular, the height of her jumps. And you see some of the other skaters, they get the rotation, but they don't have that explosive height that we saw for Grace. Much more difficult to control, thus the inconsistency. Let's take a look now at the scores for Gracie Gold.
Her short program score, 76.43.
Season's best, the best this year for any skater. 76.43 for Gracie Gold of the United States. She is in first place, getting a big hug from Scott Brown. Coach Frank Carroll looking as distinguished but very pleased as ever.
Please welcome to the ice, representing Russia,
to close the show. And what a show it has been here in Boston. These women have been sensational. 17-year-old from Russia. She was 13th at the World Championships last year, Anna Pogorelia.
Triple toe, just massive throughout the combination. Footwork triple loop. We spoke about how volatile she can be, but she looks dialed in right now. Double axel, always a bit of a scary moment for her.
think that was the best I have ever seen Anna Pogorelia of Russia skate. We'll see what the judges think in a moment. Anna Pogorelia of Russia, and Ryan, as you discussed earlier, she's been such an inconsistent skater this year, but when she's on, the big marks follow, and we're expecting huge scores here for Anna.
This is certainly going to be her personal best. This was the first time that we've seen her put every single element together. She's shown flashes of greatness. She's such a powerful jumper. We see how she flies across the ice on that triple-triple, kind of like Gracie Gold does, but today it was every single thing, no bobble whatsoever.
I felt that the music left something for me. I thought it was a little subdued for the audience, but you liked the music.
I liked her. I liked the way that she performed to the music. She was so powerful, and it really came across.
Season's best, 63.81.
Her short program score.
73.98 for Anna Pogorelia. She moves into second place. Is she going to smile?
Look how resilient she is. She just blew away her personal best. And she's like,
and
all
she's
right, I'll smile.
Trying
she knows she has work
together.
To do.
Ladies and gentlemen,
for the first time this season, she's ahead of her Russian teammates, but we saw her smile. What a beautiful performance. Gracie Gold of the United States in first place, Ashley Wagner in fourth, but Ryan, one of the best days of women's skating that we've seen in a long, long time. Saturday at 9 Eastern on NBC, U.S. national champion Gracie Gold and the leader and Olympic medalist Ashley Wagner will compete in the Ladies Free Skate, the World Figure Skating Championship, Saturday night at 9 Eastern on NBC. And after we see what we've seen in the short program, boy, a lot to look forward to. Sitting in third place, the skater who has dominated all year, Ryan, Yevgenia Medvedeva.
And it's so funny because we saw that she was human today because she didn't do the triple toe on the first jump. That was really the only thing she did wrong, and she still got the triple-triple in. She was such a strong, composed skater, and to be able to make those changes at your first World Championships is the reason that she's still in the title contention right now.
And I think it wasn't so much that she skated badly, it was the rest of the field was on fire.
This is just one of those events where we were looking at the top eight, top nine, and every girl skated so well. They went out, they delivered, and when you see this many clean programs, it really just builds the electricity in the venue.
In second place, her teammate, Anna Pogorelia, and boy, a breakout performance. I've never seen her deliver like that.
And this was her performing to the best of her ability. She has always had this strength and this power, and then you get brought back down to earth with a little bobble here or a little bobble there. And today she attacked everything, she stayed strong, and that power was just so evident all the way until that ending pose. I think that this could be the first step into her really taking off in the rest of her career.
Well, you saw her try to hold it together in the kiss and cry because she knows it is a competition that is held over 2 days, and a lot of jumps ahead of her in the free skate. Of course, she's trying to stay ahead of her teammates, and she's trying to catch Gracie Gold of the United States.
And Gracie Gold had the stage to herself. She wanted this moment to be at a World Championships as the American champion on her home soil, and she came out and she was so aggressive. Every jumping pass was done well, particularly the triple flip and the triple lutz, triple toe. And the moment when she let her personality shine and coming through and exploding through the end of this program was a moment that if Gracie Gracie Gold can continue to perform like this, it is going to be very difficult for anyone else in this field or any other field to be able to touch her on the scoreboard.
Well, her teammate Ashley Wagner is sitting in fourth place, just in podium position. It is so close with the women. And here's Yelena Radionova, the third of the Russian teammates. So a host of teenagers still to skate in the free skate, but I think everybody agrees the women put on such a show. Ashley Wagner, I think she was the one that really captured the crowd the most.
And the fact that she was not in that last warm-up really didn't do her any favors, because when the girls are skating this well and things are so electric, you can really build off of the crowd.
Well, a whole lot of more figure skating still to come from Boston. We'll have the free dances tonight. The ladies, of course, ahead on Saturday. For Ryan Bradley, I'm Tracy Wilson. Thanks for watching.